What's up, YouTube? Mitch Santona with more repaints. Wow, there's a lot of repaints coming out right now. But this one is a cool one in Protect-A-Bot Hotspot. So this is part of the Asian packaging, the Generations repaints. I've got a bunch more that I'm going to be showing off on this channel. These reviews won't be that long because they're just repaints, and I've pretty much reviewed these figures before. If you'd like to see full reviews, may even direct you to them with a handy-dandy link. But I'm just showing off the packaging here. You can see that anything that I can't read, it looks like it's been omitted here because it probably had some writing that, well, I just can't read. Now, here is his bio. Here is his tech specs. And I would say these are Asian exclusive, except they're not exclusive because I found these in my Toys R Us in Detroit, Michigan. So, yeah, just the Asian packaging, just repaints. Let's get them out of the box and play. Alt mode for Hotspot. It's a bright blue brick of a fire engine with a water cannon that poses around. We've seen it on Inferno. It's just a repaint of Inferno, but look at how bright blue and Hotspot looking it is. Oh, is it nice. Let's look it up close. A little rivets. Got some windshield washers. A little silver paint here with the lights. Clear flashers. That's always a bonus. And then I guess that's a Hotspot. That would make sense, right? Little hot spot, I suppose. Autobot symbol, a little aqua missile. Oh, this guy's just doing it for me. Here is Granddaddy. This is the original Protect-A-Bot Hotspot. You can see the same little hotspot thing. You can see that he's got some, well, some extra little, I like the red and white stripage on this guy that this guy doesn't have. So, Repro Labels, if you can hear me, red and white stripes on this guy would be so awesome. I think it would, at least. So, yeah, the only other difference here is that this guy doesn't have the ladder, as Inferno did not either. But they did make a third-party company, I believe, made a ladder kit for this. And somebody, if anyone's got info on that and wants to put it below in the comments, I'd definitely like to read about it because I'm interested. And now for the pleasure of your eyeballs. Here are their alt modes. You have Inferno, Hotspot, and Grapple. Check those three out. They look fantastic in their alt modes. One more little size comparison before we get him into his robot mode. Here he is with a current deluxe class figure. This is Transformers Prime Bumblebee. So let's get him into robot mode now. Oh, look at this robot mode. I'm totally digging it. I'm all about it. I wish there was some I wish that was a shrink ray and it would just like shrink me down to like his height so I could just give him a big bear hug around that big G1 blocky looking chest. Yeah, that's what I think about that robot mode. Now, I was saying that these Generations lines were strictly just repaints, but that's not exactly true because some of these have new heads, and this guy in particular does, and it's a really nice-looking one. And those are the two heads side by side. You can see just how new and awesome that thing looks. I really do like what they did with that. It just, oh man, it looks very comic booky. Looks very hot spot. So if you're unfamiliar with this character and who he is, well, that's the homage right there. That is G1 Hot Zone. And this guy's going to look great because I have a feeling that we're going to probably end up getting a little Repro Label set for this. And I'm hoping we will. And I hope it has some of that zigzaggy warning red and white stripe stuff all over that. That would be cool. And look at these two fellow Autobot firefighters next to Inferno. These guys look wicked. Here he is next to a more current Transformers line. This is from Transformers Prime. This is Optimus Prime, first edition. And of course, lastly, we can't forget his fellow Protect-A-Bot, Blades. So thank you for watching, people. This has been Mitch Santona. You have just seen Protect-A-Bot Hotspot, also known as Hot Zone in certain iterations. But we'll call him Hotspot. I probably have called him both in this review. But anyway, I highly recommend it, man. Totally recommend this guy, especially if you don't have this mold. It's a great blocky G1 looking mold. If you're into G1, if you're into the Protect-A-Bots, if you're into Asian exclusive repaints, if you're into cool little comic book head sculpts, if you're into water cannons and awesomeness, you got to get yourself a Hotspot. So take care. I'll see you. Arrivederci and have a great night.